film them now.
Yep.
The object of these pictures is to show how we do the hedge. A lot of people say you haven't ought to use chainsaws, but nowadays you've got to try and save yourself any sweat that you can.
Circle.
Yeah. Want me to get up there?
Honeysuckle. Horrible stuff. I think we can do without that.
All in two.
Okay, boys. what we call the heel off, that stops the chutes coming out on the opposite side. Otherwise they would rob the piece that is laid down. That is just a little piece. Now we will bind that with binders. These are hazel.
Go.
You put one binder to every stake and then you weld them in. We shall have to have another stake or two. So we'll that gives you your height. Each one. Three. These stakes are put in somewhere about 18 inches to 2 foot apart, and you tap them in a little bit with your beetle. If you don't knock them right home, in case they don't happen to be in the right place and you have to pull them out again. The next stake, over, back, over. Ready? Ready?
Right.
And you knock your stakes on. Worrying about the last ones because they will come next time. Hang on a minute. We take the tops off so that it's level. just trimmed the whiskers off so that it looks a bit neat. Okay, that's finished. Spend too long there, Ron. There's another.
Okay.
That is a piece of holly that's ever so many feet long, and it's had to be pleached in the middle as well as this end. Well, this hedge, like the one we did last year, hasn't been cut for about at least 50 years. Because I've been here 50 years and has never been cut, because it's a boundary hedge between the neighbour and ourselves. We could cut a headland and lay the hedge, and he graciously said, get on with it. This is a piece of oak that is covered a good long way. To here, all it has to do now is grow. Perhaps we might see by June whether it's been successful or not. We go along a little bit now.
Hang on, all right.
This is a piece of birch that was laid over 50 years ago, and it come up straight and bent over, then it was up straight again. So we had to put a pleach in here until the elbow hit the ground, and then we put another pleach in to lay on the top. And that one is ever so many feet long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's over 36 yards, feet. Laid a bigger bit of birch. And thank you for coming down, Ron. Right, well, we are now back to the hedge that we took the photographs of in February, just after we lost Brenda, and we've got a different photographer here who I hope, and he hopes, to be able to give you some idea of that piece there and how little there is holding it on underneath. And then we'll walk up to the end of it. Shows you how, come up here please, Peter. Although at the bottom it's nearly off, it has still survived all the way and is producing berries up here, as you can see, I hope.
Peter? Yep. Amazing.
When we go up a bit, Peter, we'll have seen me lay the piece in February and how I moaned about the honeysuckle. There is that same honeysuckle that is now dead, and that is the growth there, that piece that I laid then And these are the binders and the stakes that we put in then. And you can now see how that has come to life. It was cut in June by my grandson. It was cut the other side with a flail by my son. And I just nipped a few off, at this side now. And if you go up here please, Peter, that shows how it's taken on and how the hedge has developed all the way up. We're now going to try and show you a piece of holly, a long piece of holly, that has almost come off, as you can see, down in there, and how it goes up and is growing here, as you can see. And then if you will step back a bit, Pete, if you'd seen the first part of the film, how it was pleached in two places and then carried on, and you can now see how it shot out all the way. So try and remember what you saw in the first picture, which was done in February. Another piece of holly that, as you can see down in there, is almost cut off completely. But if you follow it along, you will see that it is still alive and shooting out well. Can we follow that up, Peter? If you walk along, Peter. This is the same piece, and in there it's cut off, almost cut off again. If you look here, Peter, can you?
Yep.
And then it's going along there, and it's still alive right to the tip and bearing fruit. Peter, we have a piece of oak that is almost cut off. It was a big piece. And now if you follow that along, Peter, you'll see that is still alive. And then if you step back, you'll see that it had to be pleached again in there. Got it, Pete?
Yep.
And it's still alive all the way along here. Growing well, right along, and then, if you can see down in there, it's almost cut off again. Ready, Pete?
Yep.
And it still goes on growing. Devote. And you, if you look there careful, you can see how it's callusing over to heal that wound. And if you look up there, you'll see it's growing all the way, stop with that, all coming out of that same piece, right along here, stop where you are, right along here, and here, and here, and here, and right back to there.
A bit of a wind today. Okay.
Now this is one of the biggest bits of birch that I showed in the first film that we took in February, how it had to be pleached until the elbow hit the ground, and then it was pleached again to let the big piece drop down on. And now you can see how that is all growing, and it's growing right along here. That's all the same piece. You step forward a piece, Peter. Right along.
Right along to there. Oh my God, that must be at least 30, 32 feet.
That's the end of it. Tell us when you got it on.
On.
Right, well, that's the end of it. And thank you very much, Peter, for coming along. And I hope it's a success.
Yeah, now looking at Sussex Master Hedge Lab, Mr. Nelson Russell.
Thank you, Ron, for coming along to try and take a picture of this hedge. Nothing had been done here for over 50 years because it was a boundary hedge, and people who owned the wood didn't seem anxious to take on the responsibility of the hedge. And it wasn't our hedge, so we couldn't do it. But finally, we got down to it. They agreed to let us do it, and that is what we've done. We started just before Christmas, and altogether it took about 6 weeks, and it is altogether 350 yards long. I'll leave you now, Ron, to carry on and take what?
Right.
First pictures we took was about one third, and now we're going to try and take some more pictures of the next third, and then we will go up to the end of the first piece and take the last third.
Right.
This is a hunting gate that is on the extreme end. And that has been there now for ever so many years. And it's from here that we carry right along. We go, there is another hunting gate into the wood a short distance along. And then you've got no other way into the wood all the way. You will note that ever so many stakes have been put along here. That is so that the boys can erect a netting barrier to stop the animals, what we call brutting the hedge. By brutting, we mean eating the shoots. They don't just bite the shoots off. They pull the shoot out, and that ruins the bud altogether. Grandchildren can graft it and produce apples. End of myth. Right. This is an unusual little bit of wood or little piece of hedge. This is bullis. Bullis is a wild plum, and we have left one piece hoping that it shoots out and makes a tree, because bullises make delicious jam. They also make a good wine. this is the end of the first section, and my son Nelson is just erecting a fence. Now you can see the finished job, the protection and the hedge. And we will take one or two pictures, please, of the last part of the hedge. The pictures we've taken so far are of one section.
Hello. Let's start now.
This is a piece of holly that has gone in. This piece of holly is somewhere about, there's only one piece of holly that fills that hole completely. If you can swing to the left a bit, Ron, you may get a picture of the whole lot. Then we'll walk along and show them sections of it. Well, this is the last of it. We are again, Ron, and as I said just now, it's the 5th of September still. This hedge is the one that we did last Christmas, and it's the same hedge as is on the film before. It's already been cut once, and this is the length that it's grown since it's been cut the second time. You wouldn't believe it would make as much growth as that in 1 year, really, Ron. Can we go along to the other gate?
Hang on.
That in piece along the top starts in that corner, and it comes along here and goes right along, and you can see all the little shoots coming out all the way, about 2 or 3 inches apart, and that piece comes right along past here and up to there, Ron. So that goes from the gate to here. That's one piece. Okay, well, here we are again. This is the piece of crab that we left for Colin, my grandson, to put a graft of an apple in. I think he's put a Howgate Wonder and a Bramley in the top, and you can see how much that's grown. And we'll go from that in a moment along to where we've got the bullace tree growing. And then I'll try and show you the fruit on that.
Right.
Now we've got to the bullace tree. That was just one stump that was left, and that is now turning itself into a tree. These pieces here, my grandson Colin has put there to try and stop the cows pulling the young shoots off the tree. And if you'll come along in a moment, Ron, I'll try and find some fruit on a piece that was layered. All right, Ron?
Yep.
This is the bullace fruit, which is a wild plum. And it makes the most beautiful jam or a very pretty rosé wine when it's harvested. It comes in after the damsons, one of the last fruits that there are to be harvested. But you wouldn't really expect to find it in the hedge.
Right.
This is a bough that has been laid down from the same stub, so that one is left and one is layered right along the hedge. Now we'll carry on.
Right.
You've got a piece of holly that starts here on, and it runs in and out all the way up here. And I don't expect you can see from there, but I can show you in a moment all the little shoots that are coming out of the main stem. And then that is a piece of hazel that runs for another 20 or 30 yards up there. Would you come this way just a bit, please, Ron? Come and take a close-up of these.
Ready.
Okay. That is some of the pieces of holly that are growing out of this main stem all along here. And it goes right back and about another 15, 20 foot back that way. And that is some of the growth that has made since it was cut somewhere about June, I would think. We had to cut it because there was so much weed, cleavers and other weeds, and that was choking it a bit. But having got them out of the way, then the hedge thrives. Just for a sec. Now this stub had four pieces of white thorn or hawthorn going up straight, and it was weak that side and weak the other side. I thought I'd be clever and try and lay two that way and two that way. The first piece I tried to lay down under there went too quick and split off, but I was successful with the second piece, and that went that way, and the third and the fourth piece went that way. I will walk up to the end and show you how long that piece was, and you'll see it growing up all the way. It comes right along here. That is somewhere about the end of it. And it goes the other way, the same distance. so that from here to the other end, that one stub is covering over 64 feet. And I think that wants a bit of beating. Thank you, Ron. Okay, Ron. Perhaps you'll get on better this way with the sun behind you. But this is where the stub starts, and it comes right along to opposite you. And that's all growing, as you can see.
How long is it now?
That one piece from here up to you is 32 feet at least, because the whole stub covers 64 feet. So that is, this is